I think the one quality that every great breeding horse possesses, and I've never seen a great breeding horse that did not possess this quality, is tremendous minds, easy to train, natural talent, and horses that, like, every day they just get better. There's not no fight to them, they just get better and better. And chromed out Mercedes definitely possesses those qualities, and his colts are very much like him. In 1976, I started riding horses for Willowbrook Farms, Tom Fuller, and he had a great stallion named Joe Cody. And the first year I rode for him, I won the Futurity on Bonita Paprika and won the Open on High Proof. And I thought they were, I'd never ridden horses like that before. And I was sold on the Joe Cody horses from the beginning. And then I wanted a son of Joe Cody, so I bought Topsail Cody as a yearling. And then I bought a very special mare that I thought could produce a stallion. Her name was Jeannie Wisbar. And in breeding him to her to Topsail Cody, I raised Topsail Wiz. And Topsail Wiz was, I mean, he just took my whole program to another level. And we had 22 fantastic years with him. And the Wiz family, they are such show horses. They just keep getting better. They're monster stoppers. But if I wanted to add a little something that I thought would improve the family, what would it be? Well, I'd like to make the neck just a little longer, maybe just a little bit more body size. And I'd like to have a horse with big, thick hoof walls that the heel grows just as fast as the toe. And chromed out Mercedes possesses all of these things. So I really thought that I could take the Wiz mares and add these qualities that I thought would be an improvement and go to another level. I wanted an outcross stallion that I thought complemented the Topsail Wiz daughters. In studying the industry, the horse that just seemed to have everything that I was looking for in an outcross was chromed out Mercedes. Well, I watched Andrea show chromed out Mercedes. I watched him prepare him. I watched him show him. That horse, he never cheated. He was so honest. Andrea could spark him in the makeup pen and take him up to the level he wanted to show at in the show pen, and he showed just the way Andrea prepared him. A lot of horses, if you spark them in a show pen, you can't get them show. But you could, I watched Andrea just build him up to the level he wanted him in the show pen, and he'd go in the show pen, and that's exactly the way he showed. That's the sign of a wonderful mind. I think a great stallion has to have a good mother. He has to have proven he's a show horse. He has to have run a major event. And people have to have liked watching him show. He has to have some popularity. When I bought chromed out Mercedes, I did an extremely intense vet check. I had every joint in his body x-rayed. And he was squeaky clean everywhere. And this is after a two-year hard show career. And then also I did a very extensive fertility check. We checked his fresh semen. We checked his frozen semen. We checked his cool semen. Everything was off the charts. I mean, I couldn't have been happier. But I really think when you're putting a breeding horse together, you have to look at everything and make sure everything is correct, and where if you want to breed mares, you're not going to have a problem in the breeding barn. So I think on a stallion, I think a fertility exam is just as important as a soundness exam. I wouldn't breed a stallion that didn't vet check. I really think when you're raising fertility horses, you're raising young horses, one of the most important things is that when you go to sell them, they get a clean vet check. When I bought him, I called Walton Bury, and I bought every picture they had ever taken of him. I had a stack of pictures of him, and Pam and I went through them, and every one of them was alike. The only difference in any of them was they were taken from different angles and different backgrounds, but every picture looked the same. You can't do that with many horses. When we bought all those pictures, all those stopping pictures of Curly, we were going through them, and there is a stopping picture of Curly that is probably one of the most dynamic pictures I've ever seen in my life. And Pam and I are right there on the other side of him, watching him in our box seats. And that picture, it's probably one of the best stopping pictures I've ever seen. And then there's a little boy right next to us that's leaning over the rail watching it with his mouth wide open. And we love that picture. That's one of our favorites. The AQHA has a deal where you can draw DNA on your horse and send it in, and they test your horse for all five genetic diseases. And we definitely did that. We pulled DNA on Chromed Out Mercedes and sent it to the AQHA, and he is negative for everything. When I first bought him, when we got him home, I stepped on him and rode him, and he just come from Andrea's house, so I expected him to be sharp, and he was. I've never rode a broker horse or a funner horse to ride. Well, then we bred him for a couple years, and we just, he'd go to the breeding barn, he'd come back, he had his grass turn out, and then he'd back to his stall, and he hadn't been ridden for 2 years. And we brought him over here, and I saddled him up and rode him, and he felt just like he did the day he come in. And now we've found that he is happier in breeding season if we lope him every day. He collects better, everything is just better. So instead of putting him in the turnout now, we lope him every day. Curly's babies are very pretty. And they're beautiful yearlings, they're beautiful two-year-olds. You know, but also there's more to that. Colts cannot be pretty unless they're raised properly. I'm a firm believer, when I wean these colts, I keep them on full feed alfalfa 24/7. I don't ever want to see their alfalfa bunk empty. They're grained every day. And I really think if you're raising a fertility horse and you want this thing at its best at 3 years old, your nutrition program, you can raise the best horses in the world, but if you don't raise them properly and give them all the opportunities nutrition-wise, you will never, no matter how good your horses are, you'll never reach your goals. I really felt that Chromed Out Mercedes was the perfect cross on the Wismares, and that we could go to another level with that cross. But you know, if he crosses on the Wismares, he's gonna cross on all of the really solid families. Like this year in our two-year-olds that we're starting, we have some tremendous colts out of Wismares. We have tremendous colts out of Smart Chickalina mares. We have out of Dennett mares. A lot of customers that have bred have called, and they're very excited about their two-year-olds. One of them's out of a Mega Jack mare. One of them's out of a Wimpy's Little Step mare. We've had several people call with colts out of Wismares and Smart Chickalina mares that have just been outstanding. So we're pretty excited about that. One of the big things we're seeing with this first colt crop is the mind that they seem to consistently have his mind, and they consistently are real soft in the face, they're real soft on the chin, and real feely in the belly. This is really a thrill to us, because that's something that we really was hoping was going to work, and it looks like it is. Every colt we've started is a very nice mover, but they all have that wet, that whiz, and that curly stop. They all turn around real pretty. They change leads effortlessly. Training them is, you just ride them every day and they just get a little better each day. But the whole package is there, and that's what we were betting on, and that's what we were hoping for. So it's really exciting to see it all come together.